Oh, yeah. Everything gonna be all right this morning. Oh, yeah.
A long generation ago, back when Chicago was still a dangerous city, Brother B ran a dingy speakeasy on the wrong side of Van Buren Street. A mild-mannered youth named Fancy tended the bar, pleasing the women of the third-rate burlesques with a mix of flattery and easy credit. When asked for a shot on the cuff, he would say,
"I wouldn't want such a good-looking girl like you going down State Street thirsty."
And would pay for the drink himself. To this lopsided shambles where the lighting was so dim that all the faces looked alike, no police ever came. But whenever a fight began, Brother B, who did not pay for police protection, hurried from behind the bar, locked the front door, and drew the shutters. All the fights were unnecessary. Except for saving Brother B the money he otherwise would have to spend on entertainment. The rumdums of Brother B's fought for their honor, for their self-respect. They fought to fill the emptiness of their lives as they filled their empty glasses. They fought for the sweet and fleeting taste of victory. Suddenly, it would be done. Brother B would raise the shutters and everyone, victor and vanquished, would have a shot on the house. The juke would start again, and everyone would feel that something had been achieved that day. The worst brawl of all was the most unnecessary. It involved the two men least equipped to fight anybody. And when it was done, Brother B lowered the shutters for the last time and closed his door for keeps. It began on one of the hottest midsummer nights the city had ever known, in a joking conversation between Fancy and a peep show peeler from the burlesque across the street, who called herself,
"Hey Venus, some rich guy was just in asking for ya. Name of Rudolph something. Valentino, I think he said."
"Oh yeah? What'd he want?"
"Said he wanted to patch things up. Had two messenger boys carrying flowers. Said he'd be back in half an hour."
"Tell Rudy not to bother me no more. Tell him we're quits."
"He won't like that."
"What do I care? Ain't I got the best man breathing? What's any of them movie creeps got that Railroad Shorty ain't got?"
"Two legs."
"That ain't nothing. You guys with legs ain't even in the same league with him."
"I heard he's a pretty good man with the ladies. Is that where he gets all his money?"
"You don't know my shorty. He don't take a crying dime off any woman. He ain't built like that. Anyone says he does, they just don't know him. They don't know how sensitive he is. They don't know what pride that man got. I'll tell you what, right there is the proudest man on earth, that's all."
"I was only kidding, Venus."
"I hope to Christ you were."
What got into that one?
"She's in a high-wheeled huff about something."
"Don't send me no angel. This city's too cold. I need a man with a black heart of gold.
Want to do something about it?"
"No, sir. I don't want any trouble."
"I figured, coward."
"I've seen dark nights, dark nights, but only the dark is a light can deliver my love. I've seen dark nights, dark nights.
I can do anything an able-bodied man can do. I'll outdrink and outfight any man of you. You name it, and I'll do it better.
Sure, sure. Just don't let me catch you on the con in here, Shorty. You know your business too good. I gotta protect my customers. They come in here to drink and fight and eat them good pretzels. I know it's tough, Shorty. You're too small to ken in the streets and too little to reach a damper. But you ought to be all right snatching Twist's purses.
I ain't got no use for a purse-snatching man. That's plain dirty stealing. I got plenty of money. I'll fight any man who says otherwise.
No one here is gonna fight you, Shorty.
They're welcome to try. Back in the old days, I had an act with Strangler Lewis. Nobody gonna get out of my full Nelson back then. Nobody.
No hard feelings. Here, have a pretzel.
Nah, too salty.
Now, Shorty, don't you go getting into trouble for that girl. That boy got a big mouth, but he's only a boy, and he don't mean nobody harm.
What girl? What boy?
Don't pretend you ain't heard a word when the whole neighborhood is talking.
Tell me what you're talking about.
You don't have to get rough. Venus told me she pays you money regular. That's what she told me.
How long have I been taking money off of you?
Huh? First you come barging in here like a tank and insult me?
Answer me.
Shorty, you got it all wrong. It was Fancy said that to me. I told him. He better not let you hear him saying anything like that.
Where'd you get them ears, Four Eyes? Look, everyone. Look at them ears on Four Eyes.
Hey, Shorty, your ears ain't that much to look at either.
What's that? You saying something about my ears, boy? What's the matter with my ears, Four Eyes?
Fancy's just saying he'd go for you, boots and shoes, if you tried getting rough with him.
He says she pays you off. That's where you get your dough.
He asked Venus why she has anything to do with a stinking halfie.
Why don't you come out on the floor and talk it over, Four Eyes?
We can talk it out over the bar, Shorty. I ain't got nothing against you. He's jealous you can't take Venus off ya.
He makes up dirty stories about you and her.
He draws dirty pictures of you and her, too.
Come out here, or I'll come and get you.
Let's see which is the best.
Give the boys room now, people.
No interfering. A square shake for everyone.
Let them have it out. That's what they want.
Back off, or I'll bean you. Farther. Back to the door. Better brain him while he's blind.
Thank you.
He's cold.
You done just right. He had it coming, Shorty.
Carpet rags from now on, son. Carpet rags before your time. Like me and all the peoples.
Like Jesus Christ riding his cross instead of carrying it.
He looks more like the devil to me.
He'll look like 20 to life if you don't keep on wheeling.
You put too much salt on these pretzels, Brother B.
Feather.